Is waiting in line to buy the next big thing in and of itself? Do people actually enjoy standing in line for days on end? And who are these people anyway? Here to tell us about so-called queue chic is MarketWatch's Charles Passy. Charles, thanks so much for being with us and coining that incredible phrase, queue chic.
I should get it trademarked, right?
You should. Is there a whole culture that is now sprouting up around waiting in line?
Yeah, I mean, look at the people who have been online for the Apple iPhone for days, and now this has become almost ritualized. Every new iPhone we expected. But also think about Black Friday and how that has kind of had its whole line thing or whatever. So we have basically had this phenomenon of the line becoming a cultural phenomenon and people really enjoying in some ways the experience of being online, which when you've waited for getting your license renewed at the DMV doesn't seem to make a whole lot of sense.
I'm going to hire these people to stand in line for me at the DMV. They clearly, it's more than just waiting in line for a product.
Right.
There's something else going on.
Well, what sort of social experts kind of call it is the idea of social proof. Basically, the idea that if you're with other people doing something, it must be right. So, you know, if in fact you want the new iPhone, then maybe you only have the iPhone 5. Do you really need the 6? But suddenly, if you're online with a bunch of people who are buying it, it confirms this is the right thing to do. At the same time, companies love it because it's essentially, look, we're talking about it right now. It creates buzz. It makes their product seem much bigger and much more important. Essentially, the people waiting outside online become free advertising for the company.
Are there sort of underhanded ways that companies encourage this?
Well, you know, I think Apple has certainly has, I don't know if I would call it underhanded, Apple has certainly made something of the line. I mean, they have, you know, sort of big things around opening day. I think they're opening the stores earlier tomorrow, so for the opening day. So I think in that sense, you know, yes, but I don't know if I would call it underhanded. There are also companies that are essentially grabbing a place online to market their products.
This crazy idea that we have to have something, though, if we can't get it, as opposed to whenever there's a lot of anything.
Right, right. It's the idea of sort of a false scarcity. I mean, it's true that, you know, the Apple iPhone, the 6, there's a huge demand for it. The people who pre-order it are not going to get it until October. There's some question as to how long. But, you know, let's be honest, your world's not going to come to an end if you were using it in November.
But, I mean, are these people taking vacation time? Who are these people? They have jobs.
Well, you know, some people are hired, apparently, to wait online. But, you know, yeah, I myself would wait a few weeks.
You need to write an article on the culture of the line. I want to know what goes on there. Thank you so much, Charles, for that.